It's pharyngeal gill slits. This is also important character of the chordata. In chordates, they are situated in the pharynx region. Their main function is respiration. They takes oxygen from the water and liberates the carbon dioxide. In some animals, gills are present throughout their life. Example, cyclostomata, fishes, and larval forms of amphibia. But in some animals, gills are absent. For example, you can take the frog. Adult amphibians do not possess gills, but larval forms possess gills. When it becomes into adult during metamorphosis, gills are degenerated and disappears. They develop the lungs. In reptilia, apes and mammals, including man, gills are absent. But gills are present in the embryonic condition, that is non-functional. They are non-functional, gills are present in the early development. That is the characteristic feature of the chordata. That is why they are non-functional, gills are present in the embryonic stages. And post-anal tail. Tail is also important character of the chordata. That is the posterior elongation of the anus, tail is present. In the tail, coelom and visceral organs are absent. No visceral organs, no coelom is present, but muscles are present and also skeletal elements are found in the tail region. Their main function is the, in aquatic animals, fishes and larval forms of amphibians, they help in swimming, locomotion. But in higher animals, it acts as a balancing organ. Example, kangaroo. In kangaroo, tail acts as a balancing organ. Or example, in monkeys also, squirrels also. When it moves from one tree to other tree, it acts as a balancing organ. But in aquatic animals, they are useful for swimming. Yes, these are the four main characters or chief characters are present in the chordata. They are notochord, dorsal tubular nervous system, pharyngeal gill slits, and post-anal tail. In addition to these four characters, the other characters are also present in the chordata. Now we have to discuss the other characters of the chordata.